So Canada loses the She Believes Cup final in penalties, falling 5-4 in penalties, but then 2-2 in the game. And I think it's good to kind of keep a note of things. I think there's two things to keep in mind for me. I think this U.S. team is definitely still trying things. So in their state, you can definitely say, hey, they aren't their full version. And this is something I've been saying about the Americans for a while. I think come the World Cup in 2027, I think whoever wins that World Cup on a women's standpoint, I think they deserve a conversation for maybe one of the better teams ever. Not because I want to discredit the former teams, but I think that when it comes to the level and the level of competition where it is, I think it's fair to say, hey, if you can dominate or win, you might be one of the better teams ever. And you're seeing old generations go, new generations come in. But without Emma Hazen, you see Tuella trying to experiment, go through things. So this isn't the best form of this U.S. team, but you do know who the big players are. I think for them, just to kind of round out my talk on the U.S., I think their best trio is Shaw, Smith, Rodman. And then you have Swanson, you have a player like Alex Morgan who's there and available. But I think Jaden Shaw, Trinity Rodman, and then Sophia Smith. I think a front three like that does create a lot of stress on your defense, and you need the right equipment. You need to be equipped with the right type of players to really defend that. And I think by 2027, they will be one of the better, if not one of the better attacking trios worldwide. But we'll see. But back to this game. I think we're talking here from a Canadian perspective. And I think the big thing for me, putting on the Canucks hat, is I think my number one takeaway from this game is the kids are all right. Now the question becomes, does that mean you don't need the vets? I don't know. Desiree Scott didn't play, but she was picked, which to me says you're looking at a player who's working their way back in. So maybe it's seeing where she is in training. That's important. But I bring up Desiree Scott because the midfield, I think, is the most interesting and fascinating spot for this team. Who are your other four? Who are your other two, really? Because based off of players and based off of where they are, I think Fleming and Owusu are going to Paris. Pick up your croissants, do what you have to do. I also think Quinn is going. Now the question becomes, do you bring in another midfielder to play in that trio, or so you have some rest? Are you committing to a duo and just going to rotate between the two? I think that's where it becomes very interesting. Because a player like Rosso was there, okay, they could be a player that could play well. But now what do you do then with a player like Olivia Smith? Can she be able to thrive in an outside position? Or does she have to play more in that 10 role? And that comes down to also formation. I think Bev has a conversation and a decision she has to make in terms of her back three. I think you need to keep that. Now the question becomes, do you now turn that to a 4-3 based off of the talent you have? I think talent dictates you. Do you need to do that? You need to do a midfield duo. But in doing so, could you get away with... I know against Brazil, they played what's being affectionately called the airplane, where it was a back three, Fleming in the middle, and then you had Deanne Rose, you had Janine Becky, I'll get to her later, Adrian Leon, Heidema, Lacaz. I think it becomes very intriguing to see where you want to put those additional players. I do think a midfield trio is important. Whether that midfielder is always in the midfield or whether they're able to drop back and provide a bit of support. You do, though, see on the wide areas when she played that 3-4-2-1 or that 3-4-3. You saw those triangles of chemistry, right? Whether it's Leon Lawrence on one side, you had Becky and Lacasse looking good together. And then up top, that's the other low-key conversation. I think if healthy, Nichelle Prince is playing. And Nichelle Prince offers you a little bit more mobility. And she provides you with more fluidity in that front three. Because if you have Nichelle Prince up there, then Leon can drop in and then Nichelle can pop out wide for some moments. Or if either it's Lacasse or Becky pop in, they can rotate through and provide a constant amount of speed and pressure on defenders. But when you get there, what are the two profiles and what do they provide for you? Heidema gives you up a different profile in terms of just an aerial threat, but also her deep playmaking has improved. Is it where you'd want it to be? No, but I think she's definitely improved. Evelyn Vienne's getting opportunities. Where do you want to put her there? So I think heading into the last few windows of it, it's interesting. I mean, we can mention the obvious things. I think penalties need to be worked on. I mean, Alyssa Nair made some great saves, but they didn't trouble her into making those saves, which I think is something that comes up. You've had the U.S. going into penalties for two straight elimination games, and ultimately, you weren't able to get it done. But you're seeing teams, you're seeing players go, and I think this could be very intriguing. I didn't expect to see Aliyu to get any minutes, so I was like, yeah, I get a minutes too. I don't think BSG is close to this 18. I think she's closer to a 23 versus an 18. But with all that being said, I think Canada's right now at their stage versus where the U.S. is, they shouldn't be afraid of them playing. I think they can play with them, but I think you do need an additional player, whether that means you switch it to a 3-5-2 or 3-4-1-2 and leave an additional player that is responsible to step back in. Think of it more of a false nine. We saw Sinclair kind of playing that role at times in her later part of her career. But a player like Chloe Lacasse or a player like, and I think Olivia Smith would suit this well, where they can step in to the midfield and play there, but then also step out. I know ideally you want a midfielder there, but then you're taken away from some more wide players. But if you go from a 3-5-2, like we saw against Jamaica, Nichelle Prince, Adrienne Leon can suit that well. And then if you put a player, even a Lacasse, there, I think you can really create some good things. But for Canada, yes, they lost to the U.S. again, but I liked what I saw. I liked the fight that they had. I also saw, you know, they were playing them well and even. I'm going to admit, I don't think this is the best version of the U.S. we're going to see. They're still in their transition. But I think heading into the friendlies and then heading into Paris 24, Canada's women's team, I think I've liked what I've seen. Now the question is, let's build some fluidity, get some friendlies in. I would love for them just to really hammer a team before, just to kind of show some goal scoring and seeing what they're able to do. But I'll leave it there, guys. If you saw She Believes Cup, what did you take from it? If you were repping Brazil, Japan, or the U.S., what'd you take from it? I think we're going to wrap it up right here.